to in there, he has glorified Ananda Tirtha. So Ananda Tirtha was the other name of Shripad Madhvacharya. So I think two or three times in this book, he has glorified Ananda Tirtha, and the connection is established there, that he had accepted Madhvacharya. But he took Diksha from Damodar Goswami Dev, Damodar Maharaj, initiation, and he took Siksha from Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur. So he is definitely in the Madhva, he has definitely accepted the Madhva Sampradaya. And he was very learned, even though he was not born a Brahmin. He was born from a Vaishya family, but he was learned in Sanskrit, schooled in Sanskrit. And became a great Vaishnava, such that, and served Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur so well that when Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur was called to Jayapur to substantiate the Sampradaya, he sent Baladev Vidibhushan in his place. So Baladev Vidibhushan had one other servant accompany him, and they went to a place called Galta, where the debate took place. Actually, where he wrote his Govinda Bhashya, because the debate which had taken place, in which he had substantiated the service to Radha, because Sri Sampradaya was saying, because the Gaudiyas are not bona fide, they do not come in a bona fide Sampradaya, nor do they have a commentary on the Vedanta Sutra, the worship of Radha Govinda should not be continued by them. So the king at that time called Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, but in his place, Baladev Vidushan came. Established the credentials of Srimad Bhagavatam as a natural commentary of Vyasadeva on Vedanta Sutra, the perfect commentary. But still, the Sri Sampradaya would not accept that argument. They wanted Gaudiyas to present a bona fide commentary of their own. So then in the evening, when he was there in Galta, Govinda Dev, the deity which Rupa Goswami had worshipped in Vrindavan, was taken to Jaipur because of the nasty Muslims that were laying siege to India. Govinda transmitted to Baladev the message that he should write his commentary as dictated by the Supreme Lord Govinda himself. So with pen in hand, for Jai Shri Radha Shamsundar Gornipal Ki Jai. For I don't know how many days, 5 or 6 days, I think he wrote what was transmitted by Govinda Dev. And he presented that to the Sri Sampradaya, and it was so perfectly in perfect a composition that nobody could create any further argument. They totally accepted it, and Radharani was put back on the altar. The Gaudiya Vaishnavas were put back in place in their position in the service of Radha Govinda. And Baladev took a certificate of acceptance from the opposite party, Shishambhadaya, of his commentary on Vedanta Sutra and their place in the Madhava Sampradaya. So then Baladev took that letter, returned to Vrindavan, showed it to his Siksha Guru, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, and all the Vaishnavas were in total bliss. And this is why Srila Bhakti Pragya Kesha Maharaj writes, their actual name for the history of Mayavad philosophy, which Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur asked him to present, that book, he says, can only be named Vaishnavijay. No other name, because the Vaishnavas are always victorious. They cannot be defeated. Hari Bol. Vanchakalpadrishta Kripasinabhija Paritanam Bhavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha.
Hari Bol, Hari Krishna, Hari Krishna. Is it translated? मेरे अंग्रेजी तो अच्छी नहीं, मैं टूटा फूटा बोल देता हूँ, वो हिंदी समझते थोड़ी बहुत. Hari Bol, Hari. Pitai Gaur Pramanande Hari Hari Bol. Om Ajnanitim Ram Dasa Jnananjana Salakaya Chakshur Urmilitam Jena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. Gurave Gaura Chandraya Radhikaya Yaistadale Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tad Bhaktaya Namo Namo. Vancha Kalpatarurvasa Kripa Sindhu Bhaivacha Patitanang Pavanibho Vaishnavibho Namo Namo. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Srivasadi Gauru Bhakta Vrinda Valhari Krishna Hari Krishna 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 Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama 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 Valhari Krishna Hari Krishna 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 Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama 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 Hari Hari. First, I am offering my unlimited obeisances to my spiritual master Nitalila Prabhishna Vishnupada Stotar Satasri Sri Sri Madhu Bhakti Sri Rup Siddhanti Goswami Maharaj. After same obeisances to offering my Sikya Gurudev Nitalila Prabhishna Vishnupada Stotar Satasri Sri Srimad Bhaktivedanta Srila Narayana Goswami Maharaj and Abhadhutu Maharaj, all Vaishnavas and all Vaishnavis. Hare Krishna. Today is a very, very auspicious day. Today is the disappearance day of Sri Baladev Vidyavasana Prabhu and appearance day. Ganga Mata Goswami, appearance day. Ganga Mata Goswami. So today is a very, very special day. Now Abhadhuta Maharaj is telling glory of Sri Baladev Vidyabhusana Prabhu. Yeah. And he took birth in the Odisha, near the Chilka Harad. Maybe my village also very near to there, you know. Here he took birth, Sri Baladev Vidyabhusana Prabhu. So he is the protect our sampradaya. Yeah, he is the protect our sampradaya. So Gurudev, sometime he told, you know, all father, they are want after me, my children, you know, my children keep this sampradaya. What is the thought of this sampradaya? What is the philosophy of this sampradaya? When some Guru Varga, he saw this thing, then they are became so happy. Oh, after me, such a my one disciple, after this line, you know, who is the prepare this line, keep, you know. So then Guru Varga there became so happy. So Baladev Vidya Bhushana Prabhu is such a person, if he did not come this world, you know, now this Gaudiya Sampradaya, you know, nobody don't know about this Gaudiya Sampradaya. So he's the established, he's the philosophy of our Gaudiya Sampradaya. And this Baladev Vidya Bhushana Prabhu, you know, when he's the Vrindavan, he's Maharaj telling so much thing about him. So he's Sikha Gurudev is the Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, he is the Sikha Gurudev. He is learning everything this from this the Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur. And when this is the Jaipur, they are the Govinda Dev, and they are also Srimati Radharani there. But they are also this Ramanuja Sampradaya, you know, they are one Galta place there, and they are Ramanuja Sampradaya, they are so much preaching of Sri Ramanuja Sampradaya. So once time they are asking this king, why you keep to Srimati Radharani, you know, this left side of Srimati Radharani? Why our Vaidic culture is that? Then you can keep to with some ladies with you if you do marriage. If you did not marriage, you cannot keep to with you. This is the opposite of our Vaidic culture. But when you read Srimad Bhagavat, Krishna, he did not marriage with Srimati Radharani. He married with Rukmini, Satyabhama, Kalindi, Mitrabinda, Nagnajit, Lakshmana. You know, he have so many queens. You know, he have so many queens. Krishna married with them. Krishna never married with Srimati Radharani. And they are telling also, you are telling Bhagavat is the, our main scripture. Why are the Srimad Bhagavat mentioning of Srimati Radharani's name? There are no any Radharani's name also there, you know. So this is the complete opposite of our philosophy. Why keep this Srimati Radharani? Another question they are do, you know, past their words.
So, heute ist ein sehr glückverheißender Tag. Heute ist der Verscheidungstag von Sri Baladev Vidya Bhushan Prabhu und der Erscheinungstag von Gangamata Goswamini. Der Baladev Vidya Bhushan Prabhu hatte sehr wichtige Stellung in unserer Sampradaya. Wird beschrieben als der Beschützer unserer Sampradaya. Jeder Vater ist glücklich, wenn seine Kinder sein Vermächtnis in dieser Welt weiterführen. Genauso sind unsere Gaudiya Acharyas sind sehr glücklich, wenn sie sehen, wie ihre Nachfolger diese Botschaft Chaitanya Mahaprabhus weiter beschützen und weiterführen in dieser Welt. So Srila Baladev Vidya Bhushan Prabhus Position war so besonders, dass wenn er nicht erschienen wäre, dann würde es die Gaudiya Sampradaya heute nicht mehr geben. So Baladev Vidya Bhushan Prabhu, er kam nach Vrindavan und er suchte dort Zuflucht bei seinem Shiksha-Guru, Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur. Und dann in Jaipur zu der Zeit wurde Srimati Radharani verehrt neben Govinda, Radha Govinda. Aber dort in Jaipur predigten auch die Nachfolger der Ramanuja Sampradaya und die waren zu dieser Zeit dort sehr einflussreich und sehr stark. So eines Tages forderten sie den König heraus und sagten sie, wieso hast du Srimati Radharani an der Seite von Krishna stehen? Das ist unsere vedische Kultur. Schreibt vor, dass nur eine verheiratete Frau an der Seite von dem Mann stehen darf. Aber wo wird beschrieben, dass Srimati Radharani mit Krishna verheiratet ist? Krishna, es wird Srimad Bhagavatam steht beschrieben, dass Krishna viele Frauen geheiratet hat, Rukmini, Satyabhami, Mitravinda, Nagnajita und andere. Aber nirgendwo wird erklärt, dass er Srimati Radharani geheiratet hat. Und außerdem im Srimad Bhagavatam wird nicht mal der Name von Srimati Radharani erwähnt. So, diese oder Idee, Srimati Radharani an der Seite von Krishna zu verehren, ist nicht autorisiert. So, das war der erste Einwand von den Acharyas der Ramanuja Sampradaya.
Yeah, they are also doing another question, you know. So, they are first worship to Govinda Dev, then worship to Lakshmi and Narayana. Then they are doing question. They are doing question. You know, they are Krishna. He took birth. He is the Dwapar Yuga. You know, well, Narayana. You know, if you read the Bhagavad, when the before creation, you know, first this navel of Narayana came, this Brahma. Then Brahma, when he search everywhere, look in their water, they cannot find out anything. Then coming to word ta and pa, well, you do austerity. When Brahma do it austerity, then Lord, he gave to this four slok, you know, chatu slok to Brahma, and he gave also this Gopal mantra, he gave this ear. Then the power of the Gopal mantra, then Brahma creation of all world. You know, this is the Bhagavad telling. So, the before creation is the Narayana, but Krishna is the came to Dwapar Yuga. Yeah? Krishna is the came to Dwapar Yuga. Why? So, Krishna is the lower, Narayana is the higher, you know. So, why you are first worship to Krishna, then you worship to Narayana? This is not right. So you are first worship to Narayana and Lakshmi, then you can worship to see Krishna. This thing also wrong thing, you know, what are doing? You know, they are doing so many questions like this, you know. But king, he don't know anything, you know. Then he sent some message to Vrindavan. If some Vaishnava, they are Gaudiya Vaishnava, they can came and establish the all thing. Now without, they are telling, take out Srimati Radharani, you know, behind from to Krishna, and first you can worship to Lakshmi Narayana, then you can worship to Radha Krishna. You know, they are then sent to this message to Vrindavan. But that time, Vishwanath Chakravarti was present there. But Vishwanath take a vow, I am never going out of this Vrindavan Dham. Always he observed this bhajan in the antar dasa, ardhavajya dasa, bahya dasa, you know, the three situations. So in the bahya dasa, he always chanting, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. For in the ardhavajya dasa, that time he do, you know, when also some consciousness is the Goloka Vrindavan, something material of all, like this pralap. And complete is the antardasa, complete is the, you know, complete entry this eternal pastime. So he take vow, I am never going outside of Vrindavan. Now coming question, who can go to there and establish this thing? Then he sent to Baladeva Vidyabhusana Prabhu. And this Baladeva Vidyabhusana Prabhu, you know, he is named the Baladeva Vidyabhusan. That title is the very high class of a title. This is the title is not ordinary. But Vidyabhusan matlab hota hai vidya mein jo bhusan hai. Kya bolte hai? Ornamental.
Decorated with knowledge.
Haan, knowledge that time. He is not ordinary. He is very great. You know, knowledge of Sanskrit. He also guidance of Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur. He learning all philosophy, you know. Jeeva Goswami who are telling, Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, Mahaprabhu philosophy, all he, from Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, he learn everything. The Baladeva Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, he know, he is the one perfect person, who is the established our Gaudiya philosophy. Then he sent to Baladeva Vidyabhusana Prabhu to Jaipur.
So the zweite Frage, die diese Acharyas der Ramanuja Sampradaya stellten, war an dem, sie sagten, ihr verehrt zuerst Radha Govinda, zuerst Krishna und danach verehrt ihr Narayan. Aber Krishna ist erst im Dwapara Yuga erschienen und Narayan war schon von Anbeginn der Schöpfung an da. Und es wird beschrieben, Srimad Bhagavatam, wie aus dem Nabel Srinarains, ein Lotus wuchs, und wie Brahma, die erste Persönlichkeit auf diesem Lotus, geboren wurde. Brahma hörte zwei Silben, Tappa, und nahm Entsagung auf sich. Und daraufhin bekam er den Darshan vom Herrn, und der Herr sprach zu ihm das Chatushloki Bhagavatam und gab ihm den Gopal-Mantra. So, schon von Beginn an war Sri Narayan gegenwärtig, aber Krishna erschien erst im Dwapara-Yuga. Das bedeutet, Narayan ist übergeordnet und Krishna ist untergeordnet. Deswegen sollte zuerst Narayan verehrt werden und dann Krishna. Auf die Art und Weise forderten sie den König heraus und sie sagten, das, was du tust, ist nicht angemessen. Deswegen, wir fordern, dass du Radharani wegnimmst. Und dann tatsächlich haben sie Radharani entfernt vom Altar von Govinda. Und der König, der selber nicht antworten konnte auf die ganzen Herausforderungen, der sandte Boten nach Vrindavan mit der Bitte, dass ein Gaudiya Vaishnava Acharyas kommen möge und dieses Tattva erklären solle. Und aber Srila Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur, er war der Führer der Gaudiya Vaishnavas zu der Zeit, er hatte ein Gelübde auf sich genommen, dass er nicht Vrindavan verlassen würde. Er war immer vertieft in Bhajan, manchmal im äußeren Bewusstsein Bahirdasha, dann hat er unablässig den heiligen Namen gechantet. Manchmal war er in halb äußerem, halb innerem Bewusstsein und manchmal war er völlig in innerem Bewusstsein vertieft, in den Spielen von Radha und Krishna in der spirituellen Welt gegenwärtig und völlig vertieft, aber und deswegen. Und er hatte dieses Gelübde, dass er nicht Vrindavan verlassen würde. Aber sein Schüler, Srila Baladeva Bhushan, er war qualifiziert zu gehen. Weil das Wort Vidya Bhushan bedeutet jemand, der geschmückt ist mit Wissen. Das ist kein gewöhnlicher Titel, sondern ein sehr spezieller Titel. Srila Baladeva Bhushan war ein großer Sanskrit-Gelehrter. Und nicht nur das, er hatte von Srila Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur die gesamte Philosophie unserer Goswamis bis ins Detail studiert. So Srila Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur verstand, dass er ist die perfekte Person, um nach Jaipur zu gehen und die richtige Siddhanta zu etablieren.
So Gurudev, you know, Gurudev nicely explained. No, they are Galtagadi, one place is the Galtagadi, where the Ganges is the manifested. Maybe you are went there, yeah? Jaipur did not went to Galtagadi. Now still that place where they are discussing about this all philosophy. Gurudev, he nicely explained, you know, who is the Ramanu Sampradaya Sadhu, their big fat, you know, very tall, look like very golden complexion, put very nice cloth, you know. One side is the so much, you know, very heavy fat, some Ramanu Sampradaya Sadhu sit down. And another side, maybe you saw Baladeva Vidyapati Prabhu picture, you know, very thin, you know, lean, thin. He have only one galavastra and half, you know, half one cloth like this dress, some very simple dress and some Gaudiya Vaishnava, also some Gaudiya Vaishnava. But some Gaudiya Vaishnava, you know, Mahaprabhu Bhakta Jata Vairagya Pradhan, Jaha Dekhi Tushtahan Gaur Narayana. Mostly Mahaprabhu devotees, they are staying very simple life, eating very simple and staying very simple like Abhadut Maharaj. Mm-hmm. You know? But their life, very simple life. And and one side sitting the, you know, Baladevita Pasana Prabhu and Sina Gaudiya Vaishnava. Lean, thin, you know, a very simple cloth. So when so now they are coming question, who is the side of Gaudiya Vaishnava, who the argument? They are telling Baladeva Vidyabhushan, he doing argument. Well, he is the food and never ud jayega. Kya bolte hai angrezi mein? Jisko food and never ud jayega, ye kya karega? Aap katha nahi sun rahe na? Isliye Baladeva Prabhu is the Baladeva Vidyabhushan is so lean thin. If doing, he can fly. You know?
Very thin light.
कहते अगर फूंक देगा तो उड़ जाएगा क्या बोलते सो ही इज द वेरी थीन सो व्हाट ही डूइंग आर्गुमेंट यू नो व्हाट ही टेलिंग इज द साइड ऑफ दिस गौड़ीय वैष्णव सो देन व्हेन दे आर रामानु संप्रदाय दे आर साधु यू नो दे आर डूइंग क्वेश्चन दे व्हेन गिव दिस क्वेश्चन देन बलदेव प्रभु विद्याभूषण प्रभु ही गिव आंसर इन संस्कृत लैंग्वेज यू नो That time Sanskrit language is the very ordinary language. He telling in his Sanskrit language, he gave to answer in Sanskrit language. So their question is the, you know, where is the Radharani in Vedas, where the Radha Krishna, you know, they are Shakti and Shaktimat, you know, Shakti Shaktiman, where any proof? Then Baladeva Vidyapati, you know, Ved, Upanishad, Puran, everywhere they are given to prove, everywhere name of Srimati Radharani. He telling, if you read the Upanishad, you know, Brihadaranya Upanishad, they are telling is the Sabai Naivarame Naivaramate Saditya Maichat, when Krishna only one. Now he is doing very sweet pastime. But how can he do sweet pastime? Then Radharani manifested on the Rasrila, Krishna standing the near the Kalpavriksha. Then Radharani, left side of Krishna, he manifested. So manifested from Rasrila, so first occur is the Ra. But when he manifested, collected very nice flower, he tried to dhabita. Dhabita run way to worship to Krishna. So his name is the Radha. So telling this is the Brihadaranya Upanishad is telling this thing. And it telling Gopal Upanishad, they are telling Radhaya Madhava Deva Madhava Saiva Radhika. Always the Srimad Radharani with Sri Krishna. And Krishna Aradhyate iti Radha, Radham Sama Aradhyate iti Radha. This Upanishad is telling why he is the Radha name. Always he is the worship to Krishna, and Krishna always worship to Srimad Radharani. If you tell the Ved, Syamam Sabalam Prapade, Sabalam Syamam Prapade. You know, there is the Ved, they are telling. So he quoted Santo all scripture, telling everywhere name of Srimati Radharani. They are always doing their eternal pastime. He gives so many, you know, quoted all Puran, all Upanishad. They are quoted so many, you know, slogans they quoted there. So telling why Srimad Bhagavata is the his essence of all scripture. Why they are not Radharani is a name there, you know? Why they are did not mention Srimad Radharani is a name?
Als Srila Baladev Vidyabhusan nach Jaipur kam, wurde die Versammlung einberufen an diesen Ort, wo sie diskutiert haben. Den gibt es heute noch, den kann man besuchen. Srila Gurudev ist dort mit den Devotees gewesen. Und dass bei dieser Versammlung saßen auf der einen Seite die ganzen Acharyas von der Ramanuja Sampradaya, alles große, schwere, gewichtige Persönlichkeiten, gekleidet in feine Kleider. Und auf der anderen Seite Baladev Vidyabhusan Prabhu, ein dünner Sadhu, nur in Chadar und so ein halber Dhoti umgewickelt und ein paar Gaudiya Vaishnavas an seiner Seite. Aber Gaudiya Vaishnavas, die Bhaktas von Mahaprabhus, ihr Schmuckstück ist ihre Entsagung. Mahaprabhu ist sehr zufrieden mit den Gaudiya Bhaktas, weil sie das Sinnbild von Entsagung sind. So diese Gaudiya Vaishnavas, die sahen alle sehr einfach und aus. So als die Ramanuja Leute fragten, mit wem sollen wir diskutieren, dann haben sie gesagt, Baladev Vidyabhusan Prabhu, dann haben sie ihn gar nicht für voll genommen, haben gedacht, das ist so ein Leichtgewicht, wenn wir einmal pusten, dann fliegt er schon weg. Und sie haben ihre Argumente vorgetragen, dann war die Reihe an, Baladev Vidyabhusan Prabhu zu sprechen, und er fing an, in Sanskrit mit ihnen zu sprechen. Fließend in Sanskrit auf ihre Argumente zu antworten. Also ihre erste Herausforderung war, wo in den Veden wird beschrieben, dass Srimati Radharani die Shakti von Krishna ist, dass sie die höchste Energie des Herrn ist. Und Baladev Vidyabhusan Prabhu gab viele, viele Argumente aus den Veden, aus den Upanishaden, aus den Puranas. Eine Zitat aus dem Brihadaranyaka Upanishad wird erklärt, dass Krishna ist die eine höchste Wahrheit. Und als dieser Krishna den Wunsch hatte zu genießen, manifestierte sich aus seiner linken Seite Srimati Radharani. So, ihr Name ist Radha. Ra bedeutet Rasa. Ras.
He sees the manifested from this is Rasa Lila, so Pashta Karida, literally the Ra.
Sie manifestierte sich vom Rasa Lila, deswegen die erste Silbe ihres Namens ist Ra. Und sie sammelte so viele Zubehör zu Krishnas Verehrung und dann lief sie zu Krishna, um ihn zu verehren. Da, so da steht für Dhavali? Dhavita.
Yeah.
Dhavita bedeutet zu bringen oder zu verehren. So.
And Ra meaning Bhakti, Adha, who is the gave to every Jiva Bhakti. This is also Radha.
Andere Bedeutung von dem Namen Radha ist diejenige, Ra steht für Bhakti, diejenigen, die allen Bhakti gibt, das ist Srimati Radha. So, dann gab er Nachweise aus der Gopal Tapani Upanishad. Und dort wird beschrieben, dass Radha diejenigen, die Krishna besser verehrt als irgendjemand sonst. Radha kommt von Aradhana. Diejenige, die Krishna mehr verehrt als irgendjemand sonst, das ist Srimati Radharani. Und er gab viele, viele Zitate aus allen möglichen Arten von Schriften, wo er diesen Punkt belegte.
Yeah, so, there again there question why Srimad Bhagavat is the name of Srimati Radharani. The scripture is the, you know, is the essence of all Vedic culture. Arthayam Brahma Sutranam. You know this law? Arthayam Brahma Sutranam Bharatartha Binirnaya Gayatri Bhasarupa So Vedartha Paribhirnita. Meaning, the Bhagavat is the all essence of all scripture. Why Srimad Bhagavat? They are not mentioning in the name of Srimad Radharani. They are doing question. Then Baladeva Vidyabhushanam Prabhu told, Bhagavat everywhere is the name of Srimati Radharani. Yeah. Everywhere the name of Srimati Radharani. They are telling why directly did not mentioning. Well, when the Sukhdev Goswami, he want to explain to Bhagavat, then he asked to Srimati Radharani, how your name I have mentioned to Srimati Bhagavat. Then Radharani, she told, you can directly did not give my name is there. If you want to give there, hidden way you can give my name is there.
Huh?
If you want to give Radharani herself, she gave order to Sukhdev Goswami. It did not direct, you know, openly not give my name, Srimad Bhagavat. If gave my name, very hidden way, you know, hidden way you can give to my name. So Sri Sukhdev Goswami, he did not give to direct the Srimad Radharani name. And who is the Radharani parrot, Sri Sukha, Sri matlab Srimati Radharani, Sukha matlab parrot, who is parrot? Plus Srimati Radharani is parrot, and he is Gurudev Srimati Radharani. So scripture telling always your Gurudev name, not taking openly. If take your Gurudev name, you know, very secretive way you can take the name of Gurudev. So he did not mentioning the openly did not mention the name of Srimati Radharani.
Als nächstes fragten diese Ramanuja Acharyas, das Srimad Bhagavatam ist der Kronjuwel aller Schriften. Und das heißt, das Srimad Bhagavatam ist die Essenz von allen Veden, ist der Kommentar zum Vedanta Sutra, ist die Erläuterung zum Mahabharat und zu allen anderen vedischen Schriften. So, warum wird dann im Srimad Bhagavatam, der besten aller vedischen Schriften, nicht der Name von Srimati Radharani erwähnt? Dann erklärte Baladeva Bhushan Prabhu, dass Srimati Radharani selbst Shukadev Goswami die Anweisung gegeben hatte, das Srimad Bhagavatam zu sprechen, aber nicht ihren Namen zu erwähnen. Er sagte, du sollst meinen Namen nicht direkt erwähnen, und du sollst ja nur indirekt auf versteckte Art und Weise über mich sprechen. Shukadev Goswami ist der Papagei Srimati Radharanis. Shri Shuka. Shri bedeutet Srimati Radharani und Shuka bedeutet Papagei. So, Shukadev Goswami ist in seiner ewigen Identität der Papagei Srimati Radharanis und Srimati Radharani ist sein Guru. Und man soll den Namen seines Gurus nicht öffentlich laut überall hin erzählen und sprechen. So, aus diesem Grund hat Shukadev Goswami den Namen Srimati Radharanis nicht direkt erwähnt.
Oh, so, the scripture name is Srimad Bhagavatam, you know? The scripture name is Srimad Bhagavatam. What is the meaning of Srimad Bhagavatam? Sri, meaning Srimati Radharani, you know? Sri meaning Sakti, Sri meaning is the beauty, you know? Sri meaning is the glory, Sri meaning is the Sakti, so many. So, Sri meaning Srimati Radharani, Mad meaning is the Prem, you know? What is the Srimad Bhagavatam? This is Bhagavatam only. This is the prem of Srimati Radharani. You know, there gave one example. You know, one rich person, what doing always he collected so much money. But this money, what doing? He gave to this the wife. And this wife is the collected, you know, nicely keep the treasure. Kya bolte? Nicely can
treasury.
Keep. Huh? Treasury. Yeah, treasure keep. Once upon a time, this wife became mad, you know. Then this take this all money and all wealth, went to roof and try to distribute everywhere. And with very poor person, you know, what they are take, they collect this all money, they become rich. Telling who is the, this is the rich person, this is the Krishna, you know. And he collected lot of money, meaning bhakti, but where he keep to Srimati Radharani. In this all treasure, all this money and ornament. Once Radharani became mad of Krishna and he went to this roof and tried to distribute this all money, you know, throw. And you are collect this money, these people, and become rich. That meaning, what is the Srimad Bhagavatam? Srimad Bhagavatam meaning when Srimati Radharani became mad of Krishna Prem and when she distributed this Krishna Prem, this is the Srimad Bhagavatam. So telling this is Bhagavatam, meaning is the Srimad, meaning this is the Prem of Krishna Prem. When Radharani is the distributing, this is the Srimad Bhagavatam.
So, the Baladeva Bhushan Prabhu erklärte, Srimad Bhagavatam, was ist die Bedeutung von diesem Namen? Sri bedeutet Srimadi Radharani. Das Wort Sri hat viele Bedeutungen. Bedeutet Schönheit, bedeutet Herrlichkeit oder Shakti. So ist eine Bedeutung ist Srimati Radharani. Und Mad bedeutet Prem oder die Liebe Srimati Radharanis. Einmal gab es einen Mann, der war sehr wohlhabend, der verdiente viel Geld und sein ganzes Geld brachte er nach Hause zu seiner Frau. Seine Frau bewahrte das alles auf im Tresor, aber einmal wurde die Frau verrückt und dann nahm sie das ganze Geld und ging auf ihr Dach und schmiss das alles vom Dach. Und alle armen Leute kamen angelaufen und haben den ganzen Reichtum eingesammelt und wurden reich. So in gleicher Weise, wenn Srimati Radharani verrückt wird in ihrer Liebe zu Krishna, und die reiche Person ist Krishna, und Srimati Radharani ist diejenige, die den ganzen Reichtum von Krishna aufbewahrt. So wenn Radharani verrückt wird in ihrer Liebe zu Krishna, dann nimmt sie diesen ganzen Reichtum Krishna und verteilt ihn überall. Und alle armen Seelen sammeln diesen Reichtum auf und werden glücklich.
Srimati Radharani ki
jai.
So then our Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur and Sri Jiva Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, you know, that everywhere they are saying, where of Srimati Radharani's name. This is the first sloka of Srimad Bhagavatam, you know, first sloka, Janma Dasya Jataha, you know. This sloka is the, you know, Balavacharya, he the explained how this sloka mentioned to Krishna. But Baladeva Vidyabhushana, Vishwanatha Thakur, when he explained completely, telling this is the only for Srimati Radharani, Satyang Paramadhimahi. Who is the supreme truth? I have meditated the supreme truth. Who is the supreme to Param? Meaning Devi Krishna Mai Prakta Radhika Para Devata. Param meaning who is the Para Devata? Meaning Krishna's. What telling Para Devata?
Supreme Goddess?
Goddess. Srimati Radharani. So I have meditated to Supreme Goddess Srimati Radharani. Well, who is the Sivala Janma Dasya Jata? From whom? Manifested this Adya Ras, Mali Sringar Ras. Yeah. So Vishwanatha Chakravarti, this all slok, very nicely he explained how this sloka mentioned to Sri Sri Radharani. So he gave example, Sukhdev Goswami, Guru Hita Srimati Radharani. So this is the rule, Prathamantu Gurum Pujyam. When you start to something, first you worship to Guru, then he is the Krishna. But Sukhdev Goswami, so first he worship to Gurudev. But who is his Gurudev? His Gurudev Srimati Radharani. So he, so Vishwanath Chakravarti tell this first sloka of Srimad Bhagavat, he is the mentioning of Srimati Radharani, the glory of Srimati Radharani.
Srila Baladev Vidyabhushan erklärte weiter, wie unsere Goswami, Srila Jiva Goswami, Sanatana Goswami und andere erklärt haben, wie Srimati Radharani überall im Srimad Bhagavatam präsent ist. Und zwar schon der erste Vers weist auf Srimati Radharani hin. Aber verschiedene Acharyas haben verschiedene Erklärungen zu diesem ersten Vers vom Bhagavatam gegeben. Srila Vallabhacharya hat erklärt, wie sich dieser Vers auf Krishna bezieht. Aber Srila Jiva Goswami und Baladev Vidyabhushan Prabhu haben erklärt, wie dieser erste Vers eigentlich sich einzig und allein auf Srimati Radharani bezieht. Param Satyang Param Dhimahi heißt es am Ende von diesem Vers. Ich meditiere über diese Höchste, so heißt diese Höchste Radhika Paradevata. Es gibt Vers in den Schriften, beschreibt es Srimati Radharani, sie ist die höchste Göttin. So Satyang Param Dhimahi bezieht sich, ich meditiere über Srimati Radharani. Beziehungsweise gleich der Anfang von diesem Vers, Janmat Yasya Yato, die von der alles ausgeht, von der was ausgeht, Adiras, der ursprüngliche Ras. Das ist Srimati Radharani. Und es macht total Sinn, dass dieser erste Vers von Srimati Radharani handelt. Denn es heißt in den Veden, bevor man Krishna verehrt, Pratamam tu Gurum Putya. Zuerst soll man Krishna verehren, den Guru verehren. Erst muss man den Guru verehren, dann Krishna verehren. So wäre es Sukadev Goswamis Guru, Srimati Radharani. Deswegen macht es nur Sinn, dass Sukadev Goswami gleich als erstes zu Srimati Radharani betet.
Yeah, this way he is mentioning everywhere the Srimati Radharani name of Srimad Bhagavat. There are so many slogans, you know. This is the Rasalila, first slogan is the Bhagavan Abhitaratri Sarad Utpurla Mallika Bhiksharantu Manaschakri Yoga Mayang Mupasrita. So when you start this Rasalila, he is telling Yoga Mayang Mupasrita. When he started the Rasalila, he is the mercy of this Yoga Maya. Who is the original Yoga Maya? Srimati Radharani. Without mercy of Radharani, impossible is the Rasalila. So when Rasalila is going, Krishna also present there. Al Chandravali, also Lalita, Vishaka, all gopis there. But when Radharani sees the left Ras, then Rasalila stops. But that meaning Raseswari, who is the Raseswari? Srimati Radha Rani is the Raseswari. Without Radharani, Krishna is even present there. But when Radharani is left, Rasalila is stopped. But that meaning without Radharani, impossible is the Rasalila. So first slok he is offering to Upanishads to Srimati Radharani. When this Gopi Geet, Jayati Te Dhikam Janmana Braja Srayata Indira, he is the Indira Sabda, meaning Lakshmi, who? Similarly Srimati Radharani. Yeah. So Indira meaning Srimati Radharani. So this way, Bhagavata every hoyar, this is the explained Srimati without Radharani. When Rasalila left, Radharani left, Krishna and Radharani doing some man. This Gopiji became Saubhagyamad. When Krishna left Rasalila and followed to Srimati Radharani, and all when Gopi searching, Hoyar Krishna, then he saw Krishna's two footprints between one very beautiful footprint, some girl. Then Sukhdeva Goswami telling, Anayaradhitanunam Bhagavan Harishwara. Plus his Gopi is the topmost Gopi among the all Gopi people. Why? All Gopi present there, Krishna, he left to everybody and take only to her. Well, who is the Sri? Well, Srimati Radha Rani, Sri Radha Rani. So there are many places mentioned the Srimati Radha Rani name. So he established Bhagavat, there is the So Gurudev is always telling, most people they are telling, Bhagavata is the glory of Krishna. But Gurudev tells, no, this is the glory of not Krishna, glory of Srimati Radharani. Well, why? Rasalila is the five prana, no? Prana of this Bhagavata. No, five prana, the five chapter of Rasalila. This Rasalila is the five chapter, is the pancha prana, five prana. You know prana?
Life, yeah.
Life, huh? Life. So there is the main, is the Srimati, there Rasalila. And what is the Rasalila established? This is the glory of Srimati Radharani. That meaning Gurudev telling, this is the glory of Srimati Radharani is there. Not Krishna's, the Radharani's glory is there.
Srila Bharati Fedabhusan Babu erklärte, wie Srimati Radharanis Name überall im Srimad Bhagavatam erklärt wird und erwähnt wird. An so vielen Beispielen hat er gegeben. Das ist der erste Vers vom Rasalila. Dort wird erklärt, wird beschrieben, Yogamayam Upashrita. Um den Rasalila auszuführen, suchten Krishna Zuflucht bei Yogamaya. Diese Yogamaya, die innere Energie des Herrn, das ist Srimati Radharani, denn nur mit Srimati Radharani findet der Rasalila statt. Als Srimati Radharani den Rasalila verlassen hat, obwohl so viele andere Gopis gegenwärtig waren, Chandravali, Lalita, Vishaka, aber als Srimati Radharani fortging, kam der Rasalila sofort zu einem Halt. Also der Rasalila, Srimati Radharani ist Raseshwari, sie ist die Herrin des Rasa, ne? So, außerdem, andere Vers beschrieben in dem Gopi Gita, dort wird Srimati Radharani als Sri, als Lakshmi beschrieben.
Srata Indira.
Indira, Lakshmi. Und dann wird beschrieben im Srimad Bhagavatam, dass Srimati Radharani zornig wird im Rasalila und den Rasalila verlassen hat. Dann ging auch Krishna, verließ auch er den Rasalila. Und alle Gopis fingen in große Trennung an, nach Krishna zu suchen. Dann wird er beschrieben, wie die Gopis suchten und sie sahen im Boden von Vrindavan die Fußspuren von Krishna und etwas, ein paar etwas kleinere Fußspuren von einer Gopi. Und sie erklärten, dass diese Gopi muss Krishna mehr verehrt haben als irgendjemand sonst. Anaya Radito Nunam. Und dass dieser Name Radito, Srimati Radharatis Name, wird dort erwähnt im Srimad Bhagavatam auf indirekte Art und Weise. So auf viele Art und Weise. Die meisten Leute sagen, dass Srimad Bhagavatam beschreibt die Herrlichkeit von Krishna. Aber Gurudev hat erklärt, dass das Srimad Bhagavatam im Grunde einzig und allein die Herrlichkeit von Srimati Radharani lobpreist.
Bola Srimati Radharani ki! Hare Krishna. And the second question, you know, there, second question is that, what is the second question? Why you worshipped first Radha Krishna? Second you worshipped Lakshmi Narayana? Yeah? Second you try to worship Lakshmi Narayana. Why? Lakshmi Narayana have no birth, you know? Not death, you know, but Krishna, he came Dwapar Yug, also, he also left this world also. So, why worship to first Radha Krishna, worship to Lakshmi Narayana? When then took this question, then Baladev Vidyaparsana Prabhu quoted so many sloka from to Srimad Bhagavat, all Puran, Brahma Sahita, he quoted so many slokas there. You know, this Brahma Sahita, you are know everybody, Iswara Parama Krishna, Sachidananda Vigraham, Anadir Radhi, Govinda Sarva, Karana Karanam. Then is the, you know, Ramadi Murti Sukala Niyamena Tishtan. There is one slope, you know. And also Srimad Bhagavat, Ete Chansa Kalapunsa Krishnastu, Bhagavan Swayam, you know, Swayam. So, Srimad Bhagavat Brahma is the telling, Aho Bhagyam, Nanda Gopa Prajogosam, Janmitra Paramanandam Purna Brahma Sanatanam. You know, see, then he quoted so many slokas to different slok. And this is the explaining Krishna have some special quality. That is four is the some special quality. This jiva, this 50 quality. This is the and Narayan, yeah. Brahma Sankar more than four quality. Then five quality, more than jiva. And more five quality the Narayan and all incarnation. But Krishna have special four quality. This is the Sarvad Bhuta Chamatkar Lila Kallola Varidhi. Meaning they are, one is the Prema Madhurjya, one is the Rupa Madhurjya, one is the Venu Madhurjya, and another is the Lila Madhurjya. Then he explained this is the four special quality Krishna. This is the four quality. Never any present to Sri Narayana and a Narayana. And Narayana, only they are Dasyaras, you know, only Dasyaras. And Sakya, little bit Sakyaras. But Krishna have complete this Mukhya Ras, you know, five complete Sant, Dasya, Sakya, Vatsala, Madhur. He explained very nicely, you know, they are how Krishna present this all quality. He that explained so many quotas and gave to many scripture. And when they are hearing this argument of Baladevi Dhabhasana Prabhu, you know, then everybody becomes surprised, you know. He is a lean, thin, you know, very thin, but he gave very argument, nice scripture example. Then there everybody accept, oh, Krishna is the Supreme Personal Godhead. Then again they are doing question, but you are have no any Bhashya, you know. You have no Bhashya. Sri Sampradaya have Sri Bhashya. This is the Nimbarga Sampradaya, the Paridhas, Parijata Bhashya. There everybody is the commentary, but you, where are your commentary? Then he's telling, you know, so this is the Garuda Puran telling Arthayam Brahma Sutranam. Arthayam Brahma Sutranam. This is what is the Srimad Bhagavat? This is the commentary of this Brahma Sutra, Srimad Bhagavat. You know, Bhartartha Virinaya, this is the Bhagavat, everything. So Mahaprabhu, you know, he never writing any commentary. Why this scripture telling the Arthayam Brahma Sutra, no, without commentary, you know, necessary one sampradaya, necessary three scripture you have commentary. Then somebody accept you are the proper sampradaya. You have not three scriptures commentary, anybody not accept. Even Sankara sampradaya, they are also commentary of three scripture. What is three scripture? One is the Srimad Bhagavat, commentary necessary, and the second is the Bhagavad Gita. And the third is the Upanishad. Yeah. Huh? Vedanta Sutra. Yeah, Vedanta Sutra.
Srimad Vedanta Sutra.
Commentary of Vedanta Sutra. And the Upanishad and Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita. If you are three commentary the scripture, then somebody accept you or you are proper sampradaya. Well, where you have commentary? Then telling, okay, you can give it to 7 days, he pray to Govinda Dev. And Govinda will tell you, don't worry, you can write, take your pen, your hand, and everything I can inspire to you. Then he 7 days writing, this is the commentary of Sri Vedanta Sutra. When he is saying, they are very surprised. Only 7 days, you know, writing commentary. And my Gurudev telling, this commentary is the another sampradaya commentary. Only they are saying, only Dasyaras. Baladeva Vidyabhusana Prabhu is saying there is the Madhur Ras. Until how he is the present, until Madhur Ras, you know, this is the Vedanta Sutra. So they are becoming so surprised. And I said, they are becoming so surprised. Then he the established Gaudiya Vaishnava, he is the glory, he is the established there. If he don't came this world, all sampradaya almost finish, you know. So he keep the our sampradaya, establishes our sampradaya.
Der zweite Frage der Ramanujas war, warum verehrt ihr zuerst Krishna und dann Narayan? Sri Narayan wird nie geboren, aber Krishna wurde geboren in Dwapara Yuga und er verließ diese Welt auch wieder. So Krishna muss Narayan untergeordnet sein. Aber Sri Baladev Vidyabhusana Prabhu gab so viele Argumente und so viele Zitate aus den Schriften, um zu beschreiben, dass Krishnas Stellung höher ist als die von Narayan. Ne, er gab Nachweise aus dem Brahma Sanghita, Ishvara Krishna Satchitananda, Vikaha Anadi Adi Govinda Savakarana Karanam, Rama Di Mutishu Kalani Yamena Tishtan. Ne, er gab Nachweise aus dem Srimad Bhagavatam, Iti Chang Sakala Pungsang Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam und aus so vielen anderen Schriften. Er erklärte, dass die gewöhnlichen Lebewesen haben 50 Eigenschaften im begrenzten Maß. Halbgötter wie Brahma und Shiva haben 5 Eigenschaften mehr, ja, im größeren Maß 55 Eigenschaften. Lord Narayan und seine Inkarnation haben noch 5 Eigenschaften mehr, 60 Eigenschaften. Aber Krishna besitzt noch 4 Eigenschaften mehr, die niemand sonst besitzt, nicht mal Lord Narayan oder seine Inkarnation. Ja, das sind die, dass Krishna seine wunderschön auf seiner Flöte spielt, Venu Madhurya. Rupa Madhurya, die Krishnas Schönheit, die unvergleichlich ist, selbst nicht mit der Schönheit von Narayan vergleichbar ist. Lila Madhurya, Krishnas einzigartige Spiele, wie der Rasa Lila, die keine andere Inkarnation ausführt. Und Prema Madhurya, die Krishnas Geweihte, wie die Gopis, die solche einzigartige Liebe für Krishna besitzen. Er erklärte weiter, dass Sriman Narayan nur Dasyaras verehrt wird oder ein bisschen im Sakyaras, aber dass Krishna auch alle anderen, das Objekt, Gegenstand von allen anderen Rasas ist, bis hin zum Madhuyaras. So, er gab so viele Zitate und Nachweise, dass die Ramanuja-Acharyas gezwungen waren, das anzuerkennen und sehr respektvoll wurden. Aber dann fragten sie, wenn ihr eine echte Sampradaya seid, wo ist euer Kommentar zum Vedanta Sutra? Jeder echte Sampradaya muss Kommentare zu 3 Schriften besitzen, nämlich zum Vedanta Sutra, zu den Upanishaden und zur Srimad Bhagavad Gita. So wirst euer Kommentar zum Vedanta Sutra. Baladev Vidyabhushan sagte, das Srimad Bhagavatam ist der natürliche Kommentar zum Vedanta Sutra. Der Srila Vyasadev hat das Bhagavatam als eine Erläuterung zum Vedanta Sutra gesprochen. Und er gab auch den Vers dafür, der das beschreibt. Aber diese Pandits wollten es nicht akzeptieren. Sie haben gesagt, wir akzeptieren euch nur, wenn ihr einen eigenen Kommentar zum Vedanta Sutra habt. Baladev Vidyabhushan Babu sagte, okay, gebt mir 7 Tage Zeit, ich werde einen Kommentar vorlegen. Und er betete zu Sri Govindadev. Und Sri Govindadev sagte ihm, beginn zu schreiben, ich werde deine Feder führen, ich werde dich inspirieren zu schreiben. Und Baladev Vidyabhushan schrieb in 7 Tagen einen Kommentar zum Vedanta Sutra. Und dieser Kommentar ist einzigartig. Alle anderen Kommentare zum Vedanta Sutra beschreiben das nur bis zum Dasyaras. Aber der Kommentar von Baladev Vidyabhushan Prabhu gibt einen Kommentar in allen Rasas bis hin zum Madhuyaras. Und deswegen wurde dieser Kommentar Baladev Vidyabhushans wurde bekannt als Govinda Bhashya, der Kommentar, den Govinda selbst gesprochen hat. Und als die Pandits diesen Kommentar hörten, waren sie sehr, sehr erstaunt.
So, all Sampradaya necessary 3 scripture committee of 3 scripture, Bhagavad Gita, Veda, Sutra and Upanishad, then somebody accept your Sampradaya, the Vana Vaidya Sampradaya. Yes, sir. You tell, okay. Blessy Balade Vidyabhushan Prabhu ki, Blessy Biswanath Chakravarti Thakur ki, Blessy Aparikara Gaur Hari ki, Blessy Lila Prabhupada ki, Blessy Sri Gurudev ki, Nithai Gaur Premanande Hari Hari. Arati, finish? Okay, Arati has gana. Okay? Huh?
Arati, it's late.
Okay, late, oh, okay.
Arati, there away.
Arati, Bihari ji. हरे कृष्णा हरि बोल हरि बोल किवा जया जय घोरा चांदेर आरती को शोभा जय जय घोरा आरती को शोभा जाह्नवी तट बनेर जग मन लोभा जाह्नवी तट बनेर जग मन लोभा जग जनेर मन लोभा जग जनेर मन गौरंगेर आरती शोभा जग जनेर मन लोभा गौरंगेर गौरंगेर आरती शोभा जग जनेर मन लोभा गौरंगेर आरती शोभा जग जनेर मन नित गौर हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि दक्षिण नीताय चार वाम गदाधर दक्षिण नीताय चार वाम गदाधर निकटे अद्वैत श्री बास छात्र धार निकटे अद्वैत श्री बास छात्र बाबी हे अच्छ गौरा चार रत्न सिंहासनी की बाबती रत्न सिंह आरती करे न ब्रह्मा आदि देव गानी आरती करे न ब्रह्मा आदेव गानी आरती करे देव गानी आरती गौरंग रति काले देवगनिया रति करे गौरंग देवगनिया रति कर अमर जया कर बोले रति करे अमर जया कर बोले Yeah.
Karanda, Kol Karata, Madhur Madhur, Madhur Bhaji.
Oh, Shri Ramananda Rishukramanaka Prashadabhanik Jai Nam Chade Hari Rastakur Ki Jai Prem Sigur Ho Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gandhar Shri Vasari Gaur Vaidya Jai
See, in the deep Mayapur ki jaya, Shri Brajmandu ki jaya, Purushim Shetra ki jaya, Shri Hankun Radhikun Ganga Jamana Trusti Bhakti Devi ki jaya. Shri Nasinga Nengo Man ki jaya, Bhakti Pallad ki jaya, Kupashwara Mahadev ki jaya, Purnamasi Yoga Maya Asta Sagyasa Manjari Jaya Subhan Ram ki jaya. Hare Ram San Kirtan ki jaya, Shri Stuttgart Gurimad ki jaya. Shri Prachidar Maharaj ki jai, Bho Brahmanavade Hari Bho, Jai Shri Radhe Shyam.
Nice picture. Flower and collections. Flower. This all flower.
Yeah. Room wieder einsammeln. Das Mahaprasad.
The Mahaprasad. Cake. Maharaj can cut cake. Maharaj.
Is this for school?
School cake.
Everybody sings our God Madhura today. Shalam is also only sweet today.
Everything is so sweet. We must eat all the sweet.
Pardon. Yeah, it's broken.
Das ist auf Dach mit Bruch und Bruch. Außer gar nichts von weiter. weiß, was er noch hier. Einfach Blumenkohl oder Brokkoli kochen.